Intellectual frog legs, you make me want to be a better man.
This is Alpha Control. Countdown minus 19 seconds and counting. All systems are green and go. Countdown minus 10 seconds. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Blast off!
The scientists got a sample of Obama's DNA and they separated it. Well, long story short, without further ado, meet Obama's white half. Just say no to genetic tampering. Our royal family, you know, Queen Michelle and Prince Curtainrod. You know, these guys sit in a private plane to pick up their dog. No joke. Either that or Obama was ordering out. Called for delivery. They sent a private plane for their dog. And they didn't just send any plane. They didn't send like an ordinary private plane, like a Cessna or something. They sent a military plane. One of those airplane helicopter hybrids. How is this not just a giant middle finger right in the face of every American? Spending more on a plane trip for their dog than most Americans make in a year. Oh, not to mention they had to carry his bags of presidential basketballs. I bet that's the only bag of balls that some bitch has. You know, it'd be funny if it were a sitcom, but it ain't. This is reality. Reality, and it's a serious one. You know what? All good liberal Democrats get away with the most wildly irresponsible behavior. And it's not because we allow it, but because our government-run media allows it. Basically, our new fourth branch of government. And welcome to this special edition of Intellectual Frog Legs. Gonna raise hell, gonna raise hell, gonna raise hell. Gonna raise hell, gonna raise hell, gonna raise hell. First off, I'm calling this the conservative's guide to the galaxy because as much as we think we know, the media's got us running in 100 different directions at one time. We never focus. Never focus. We got Benghazi and Fast and Furious and the $16 trillion debt and the IRS gate and abortion doctors flushing babies and amnesty. Stop it. Stop it. We got to focus. You know, first we have to understand that we're not going to fix any of these problems, none of them, until we deal with our biggest enemy. And it's not the government. It's the media. The government would be helpless without this media. And the media is the most important thing that we as conservatives, we don't get it. We never have. You know, conservatives have always considered the media to be like background noise. You know, we'll just let those little entertaining liberals have the media dance for us. Well, that's turned out well, hasn't it? And despite the now obvious need to be doing something about the media, conservatives still don't invest in media. I mean, look, the Washington Post just sold. No conservatives stepped up. Now the Koch brothers, I thought they were buying the Tribune papers. But anyway, but like Facebook, we complain about Facebook, we complain about YouTube, but we have no serious conservative efforts. But we need some financial heroes, like Chaim Soliman. Chaim was a major factor in financing our victory against the British in the Revolutionary War. Financial heroes, we need you guys. Holy cow. But we don't get it. But we have to understand, the media is society's Novocaine. It is. But as conservatives, you know, we embrace facts and history. You know, we know that lower taxes generates higher revenues. History shows us that. We know that peace and prosperity can only come through strength, because history teaches us that. But no matter how smart, no matter how rational, and no matter how articulate our arguments may be, they will never be seriously heard or considered while these loudmouth communists keep drowning us out with their network microphones.
Some men just want to watch the world burn.
This is what we have to do. There's an invisible digital money stream, and we need to damn that son of a bitch up. I mean, this money stream generates massive revenues to this mainstream media. Not just online, but on your TVs too. And I use the term invisible because you don't see the money changing hands. And as a rule, people don't think about what they don't see. But guess what? We're all components. I swear, there's monetary value set on your clicks, just as there's monetary values on your views. Well, it doesn't matter if you're online or watching on your TV, and it's going to vary from network to network and side to side. So we got to turn them off. Don't watch their networks, don't watch their videos, and don't click their links.
Turn their asses off.
Look, every time, without exception, a true conservative begins to generate positive publicity, the more they become a target that must be destroyed by this media. I mean, that's why you can't name one popular conservative. And I don't mean Republican. Conservative. There's got to be some of you Democrat voters out there that aren't full-blown communists yet that find that a tad odd. But we got to stop helping them.
I hope there are no climate change deniers in the Department of the Interior.
Well, on a scale of 10, I'd have to give her a 2. And that's only because I've never seen a 1 before.
Hey, you got some of these people with good intentions saying, well, let's send some hateful emails. They don't give a damn about your emails, and they don't give a damn about your letters. Or then these other folks will say, sign my petition and let's demand the mainstream media tell the truth. They don't give a damn about your petitions either. They don't care if you're watching because you're mad. The fact that you're watching. So we got to turn their asses off.
Less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more fight, a little less fun. A little less fight, a little more smart. Close your mouth and open up your heart. And maybe satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby.
Some of the excuses are hilarious. I watch them because they can't brainwash me. They don't need to. Or the other one is, I just watch so I can do my research and see what the left is doing. You don't need to watch. Or another favorite is, I just watch the entertainment programming because I know the news lies. That's like saying, I'm going to quit buying my underwear and socks at Target. And I'm only going to buy everything else there because I want to send a message.
Oh, I'm so happy for them. I don't know what that...
Over the past couple of weeks, we've had some conservative groups drop intellectual frog legs. We've been 86'd. Because I made them mad. They dropped me instead of dropping the liberal media. You know what? I'm not going to be lured into a war with these guys. You know, that's what we need. Let's have some more unproductive infighting. And it's only going to benefit the left. You know, it ain't going to help us. What I did, I actually sent these guys a sincere letter pointing out this invisible digital money stream that we got to shut down. Asking them to join us. Because we need them. I mean, we need every heart and mind we can get. Save this country.
Let us be aware in these infant years of our beloved republic, there are those who wait to celebrate our failure. Be not disheartened. This will always be so, for we have lighted our candle of liberty in a dark world. and each of us is in charge of keeping it lighted.
You know, our government may not be transparent, but our media damn sure is. You know, y'all remember the Bible miniseries just a few months ago? I mean, this thing generated insane numbers. It rolled through the ratings like a tsunami and generated massive advertising revenue. So why on earth would they not do more of this type of programming? I'll tell you why, because it represents the worst of the worst of what these anti-God media commies find contemptible about America. Christians, Christianity, and our rich Christian heritage. And we do have a rich Christian heritage. They just hate it. Just look, Christians are regularly portrayed as fruitcakes on TV. And don't forget ABC show Good Christian Bitches. I'd like to see them do Good Muslim Bitches. I bet that'd work out good, huh? I think it'd solve a couple of problems at once. Anyway, but the sad thing, the only thing that trumps making money for these anti-God media commies is their political agenda. Every time. There is no other explanation for not pursuing films that are in such demand by millions of your viewers and that are such huge money makers. Pleasing the government trumps pleasing the masses. And that is what makes our mainstream media so dangerous. Government freaks, you know, that are burying our kids under a mountain of debts. We all agree it's such an immoral and profound betrayal of our children. But tell me, how is it any less of a betrayal for us to knowingly refuse to change our behavior? Stop cooperating. You know what, this phenomenon of Americans hating America? This just started after these 1969 Free Love Woodstock freaks started getting positions of power. This is the first generation of Americans to be ashamed of America. And it's entirely out of ignorance. I mean, have you seen the 100-year-old 8th grade test? I actually posted it over on the website. I challenge you to go take it. If you don't think we've become a country full of dumbasses, go over there and try to take it. Anyway, back on the media. If our media...
We're on the media again?
Yeah. You know, today, if our media teamed up with Hollywood, it'd probably be for somebody coming out as gay, or if they were having a Karl Marx birthday bash, or maybe if they're just having a Bash America party or something. Their contempt for America is just... inconceivable to me, because it was a lot different when I was growing up, and I ain't that old.
John Wayne, starring in Swing Out, Sweet Land, with Ann Lager, Lucille Ball, Jack Benny, Dan Watkins, Roscoe Lee Brown, Glenn Kemp, Johnny Cash, Roy Clark, Bing Crosby, Phyllis Diller, the Doodletown Pipers, Lauren Green, Celeste Holm, Bob Hope, Michael Landon, Dean Martin, Ross Martin, Greg Morris, David Nelson, Rick Nelson, Hugh O'Brien, Dan Rowan and Dick Martin, William Shatner, Red Skelton, Tommy Smothers, Leslie Owens, and Dennis Weaver.
The time for playing games is over. It's done. You know, well, now we've got too many opportunists in the conservative media and not enough patriots. And I apologize for sending you guys over to the, what's it called, Tea Party community. They're a joke. Rhinos. But it's all a game to these people. All a game. And it's a big made-for-TV game.
I say, let them crash.
And you know, the liberals have no game if conservatives would refuse to play. You know, we're in a battle for the heart and soul of this country. I mean, and we're losing. Look, not just losing, we're getting whomped. You don't negotiate and debate with people that steal from their own children. You kick their ass. Well, like I said, infighting between conservatives or right-leaning people ain't going to help anybody but these radical lefties. So, being respectful and without starting fights, we need to persuade these folks, especially your influential conservative media groups, to stop. Please stop driving traffic and revenue to the government-run broadcast media. Stop. Please. I mean, I'd love to shut down every single anti-American company, but we gotta be realistic. We gotta focus on the ones that control the microphones that keep drowning us out, the ones that demonize any popular conservatives. And watch out, Ted Cruz, here they come. CNN's already playing the birther card on him.
Already generating lots of buzz about the 2016 race for the White House. However, the question isn't only will he run, but can he run under the U.S. Constitution?
By the way, you know what? If it weren't for Facebook and YouTube, I wouldn't have a voice. Because our conservatives won't invest in a serious alternative. If they did, I'd be right with them.
Here's the news. Coming to you every hour on the hour.
And we absolutely do live in a digital economy. Our digital activities are trackable. They're monetized. And whatever you're doing, you're helping somebody. Because if you're online, you're helping somebody. Watching your TV, you're helping somebody. Because in a digital economy, you have invisible money streams. And the ones feeding these radical lefties in the media need to be shut the hell down. Because I'm telling you, if we don't, you better get used to the name of President Clinton again. Ooh. Buenos dias. Your nombre is Pablo Cruz. Nothing starts my day out any better than wearing my Moon Battery t-shirt and drinking out of my Wild Bill for America, a handsome coffee mug. And I'm smarter than anybody in the back of the truck. We no trim the bushes. We no trim bushes. We're gonna be doing some more funny stuff. You know what, this media thing is just, it's just too important. I mean, yeah, I'd love to be talking less about them. But the media is a common thread to every problem that we face. Every one of them. I'll tell you right now, a conservative butt will never, ever again warm the president's chair if we don't do something about this media. You know, we have to understand this new digital economy, and we need to learn how to use it. Instead of letting them use it against us, the thing about this is that even if you're broke, you've got some power here. Your clicks. And you know what? Even if you can't shut off all the media, God bless you if you can, but our focus needs to be on the major broadcast networks, the major news networks. NBC, ABC, CBS, CNN, they're all their affiliates, and basically every newspaper. Every newspaper in the country. And we're gonna need some more bird cages.
Thanks, Arthur.
Anyway, thank you guys so much for being here. Please stop by the website at intellectualfroglegs.com. Sign up for the show alerts. And there's links over there to join me on Facebook and Twitter. God bless you guys for the awesome donations. You know the song. You probably know the song by now. Frog legs are free to watch, but they ain't free to make. Okay, we'll work on that. Anyway, please share the show with your friends. Or, if you want to have a little extra fun, share it with your enemies.
What you feel, 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 what you fe eggs.